Have you heard about IO-Link? IO-Link is an amazing technology which revolutionized the way we use sensors and actuators. So let's see, what is an IO-Link? IO-Link is a first standardized IO technology worldwide for the communication with sensors and actuators. So it has basically three main features. The first feature is point-to-point communication link between the controllers and sensor or actuators. This is amazing because this is the fastest technology for sensors and actuators. The second is transfer of parameter via Profinate while the sensor actuator is operational. So you don't have to halt your machine to parameterize your sensor. You can do it while the machine is running. And the third amazing feature is you can access diagnostic information in real time. So if your sensor fails or some mishap happening, you can access the diagnostic information and can replace the device without any breakdown. So let's take an example, what will happen without an IO-Link generally in an industry. So suppose you are on a shop floor with some sensors and actuators, and the shop floor is controlled by some controllers which are linked to the shop floor via Profinet or by wired communication. Now this controller is further linked with visual interface and SCADA MES for monitoring and controlling at higher level. Now imagine a situation, there is some sensor or actuator malfunctioning and you have an alarm. Now what will happen when you have an alarm? The supervisor will alert the team, and when the team comes, they might see some bunch of wires because there are so many sensors and actuators in a big plant, and sometimes it's hard to troubleshoot that, which might confuse the maintenance team and will result in large breakdown with loss of production. Now this is very typical case when you work without IO-Link. Now let's see how IO-Link can resolve this problem. In this situation, the sensors and actuators are linked via Profinet to the controller. So you have three main features which we already discussed in this IO-Link. You have point-to-point communication, access diagnostic information, and transfer of parameters via Profinet while sensors and actuators are operational. So now in this case, when you have an alarm, the alarm will alert the supervisor, and the supervisor will send a diagnostic information to the team. Now in this case, the team knows where exactly is the sensor and they will just go and replace it because it's quite easy to troubleshoot. So this is how IO-Link is revolutionizing the way we use sensors and actuator. Now they have their own individual point-to-point communications. So now let's see more benefits about IO-Link. The first benefit is flexible wiring. You can easily connect your IO-Link sensors and actuator via M5, M8 and M12 connectors. Second of all, you have fast data processing. It is capable of processing 8-bit, 12-bit and 16-bits of data in just 400 microseconds. And thirdly, you can easily parameterize your sensor. You can send the parameters to the sensor directly via Profinet. You can read more information at www.iolink.com. Now in this video, we'll see an IO-Link system by IFM. IFM has their own IO-Link complete system which you can install in your machine and have all those benefits. So today we will see something about IO-Link Master. So this is the interface which interface your IO-Link sensors and actuators with the controller. So the controller could be a PLC and the interface is Profinet. So this can be linked via series in a multiple loops, and these interfaces are 24 volt actuated, and in below in these four ports you can connect your sensors or actuators. So this single port can be used for process value and can be used as an input or as an output, but we have to define it. So this was the basic IO-Link system by IFM. Now let's have a look at the starter kit IO-Link Master which is introduced by IFM. In the starter kit we have various components. This kit includes 4-port IO-Link master with Profinet interface, a power supply, an LR device to record the parameters, and a photoelectric IO-Link distance sensor with some cables. And in this video, we will see what does the starter kit includes, how to link the various components in starter kits, reading sensor value with and without IO-Link. Now let's see a starter kit. Now this is my interface. In this interface, if you see closely, we have two Profinet ports which you can link to your MES SCADA or to your PLC. And then you have a power port which requires 24 VDC for the operation, and then you have four individual ports for connecting the sensor or actuator. So this is the main interface. It's called AL1100. And now along with this interface, we also have some more components. The first component is a distance sensor, which is provided with a range of 3 to 200 centimeters with a special port, which you can connect to your IO interface. And along with this sensor, we have an Ethernet cable. This Ethernet cable can be linked to your Ethernet device and to these one of these ports. This can go to your PLC or a switch. And along with this Ethernet cable, you also have a power adapter. Now this adapter can be plugged to the I/O interface, and this provides 24 volts to all the sensors. And along with this power adapter, you have a software which is used to send parameters to the sensors, and the software is called line recorder. So this starter kit includes the software in a pen drive, and in this pen drive you also have a license to use the software. I will keep it here. And along with this line recorder, you have some catalogs and manuals which you can read, and you can get more information about the various other sensors and actuators available with IFM. So you can check which sensor suits to your requirement, and you can directly see the compatibility and order. This is the complete kit provided by IFM. We call it Starter Kit IO-Link Master. Now next we see connecting Starter Kit IO-Link Master. So how to connect the starter link? There are a few basic steps to connect Starter Kit IO-Link Master. The first step is you have to link your sensor. To link the sensor, just connect this port directly in any of this interface. So I will quickly connect this port. So once the sensor is linked, the second step is you have to link the Profinet. So we have a Profinet Ethernet cable which can be used to link. This can go to your Ethernet device or to the controller directly, or this will go to your Profinet. And this will go to your Ethernet switch, or you can directly give it to your router, however your system is linked. Now the last part is we have to connect the power to our power terminal. Now I power up my device, and you can see some indications on the interface. This green light indicates the ports are securely connected, and when this orange light blinks, it means it is communicating with my controller. This port has been configured. If the PLC ports are not configured, or if it is not connected to the PLC, you will see a red light blinking here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug out my PLC, and then you will see this light will blink because this is not interfacing with my PLC. So I plugged out my PLC and you will see this red light is blinking. Okay, and there is no orange light blinking because it is not reading or writing information in the Profinet. So what I do is I just plug in my PLC again, and now you will see this red light will go away. It will take a couple of seconds. You can see this orange light is blinking, trying to build communication with the PLC, and once the communication is built, the red light will go away. So this is how you can also troubleshoot your I/O interface based on the LEDs. So this was like how you connect your starter IO-Link Master with the IO-Link sensor. And now we'll see a small demo. I will take a box to read the information the sensor is sending, and you will see some readings on the top which is reading the distance between the sensor and the box. So you can see the distance varies when the box distance varies. So you can read the information on the sensor about how far is the object from the sensor. This information is given in centimeters. When the object is too near, when it's too close, you will see positive and negative buttons to set the set points, but when it is too close, there is no output. These are the buttons for changing the set points. Alright, so this was about connecting Starter Kit IO-Link Master. Now we are going to see the two different ways to use the IO-Link sensor. The one way is to use the IO-Link sensor without IO-Link Master. So we don't have the IO-Link Master interface, we don't have AL1100 interface, so the only information we get from the sensor is whether the object is present or not. So when the object is present, we get a high true bit. When the object is not present, we don't get that bit. So we just get the information if the object is in the range or if it's not in the range. And you can of course change the range from the sensor. You can go to the sensor, press the button, and you can change the range. So this was the digital output from the sensor. Now we will see a sensor with Smart IO-Link Master. So we have linked my sensor with the PLC, and you can read the information directly in the PLC about the distance. So if you see the distance on the sensor, it is reflected in my HMI. so I can read how far is my object, and with this information I can design some analog logic, and we can make some proportional logic, because now we have an information, the analog information of the object, how far is the object from the sensor. This you can see on my HMI, and you can also see the diagnostic information on the HMI. Also, when the object is too close, valid output bit get false, which indicates sensor is dusty or it needs to be cleaned. This differentiates the sensor behavior as compared to normal operation. In normal operation, you will get the ranges, but when the sensor is too close, you will get the bit false. So this was about the usage of IO-Link sensor with IO-Link Master, making it smarter. So if you have a similar application, don't wait and install IO-Link to get information from your machine minute by minute. You can also buy the starter kit IO Master at reduced price from this link. The link is also given in the description. In the next video, we will see how easy it is to link starter kit IO-Link Master with Siemens S7-1200. So thank you for joining. I hope I'll see you in the next video.